Greetings, I'm Mr. Spiffy, and welcome to the bottom of the barrel. This Sunday is No Way Out. And while we've gone through our go-home shows at this point, we had an excellent Raw and a mediocre SmackDown, although the first about 20 minutes of it was pretty decent, and the ending was solid enough to definitely cause a stir for the pay-per-view itself. So I'm here to kind of give my predictions for the upcoming event. First of all, I gotta say, the last 3 months before the pay-per-views, all of the go-home shows were relatively lackluster to average at best. This one had the first solid Raw go-home show, and I'm afraid it means that this pay-per-view is gonna be utter shit. Well, let's run down the lineup and see if we can't dig some gold out of the shit. So, first of all, we have... Sorry, I'm having trouble remembering matches. Pardon me. So, first of all, we've got, on the pre-show, Brodus Clay versus David Otunga. They did a decent job of at least giving us a little bit of a build for this on SmackDown, with David Otunga attacking Brodus Clay and leaving him in the ring. Means that Brodus will probably be tested at least a little bit in this matchup, which is good. They've been testing him more often. Whether or not he's going to come out on the... whether or not Otunga is going to come out with a win, I'm still going to have to go with the Funkasaurus. I say he's going to win. I don't see this match lasting very long. Otunga will probably dominate a good chunk of it, and then Brodus will do his typical comeback and win. Nothing too special about it. We have a United States Championship Tuxedo match. Now, I don't know if this was just announced on WWE.com or through Twitter or something. I just read it on here. I didn't even see it announced on SmackDown. Of course, the version of SmackDown I watched is relatively edited. It is the internet. I tend to catch the international version because, you know, I don't always have time to stream it, so I watch on YouTube. And it's a tuxedo match. Santino Marella defends the United States title against Ricardo Rodriguez. First of all, who the fuck has Ricardo Rodriguez defeated in one-on-one competition to even remotely earn him a United States Championship match? No one. When was the last time Santino defended the fucking title? Like 2-3 months ago. And now he's defending it against Ricardo in a tuxedo match. Damn, that's just terrible. You know, I hate to say that, you know, Cody Rhodes was absolutely right, but Cody Rhodes is absolutely right. The United States Championship has become a complete and utter joke. You know, it's sad. It's really sad. The Intercontinental Belt has finally gotten back to its illustrious history, and the U.S. Belt has an equally illustrious history, and right now it's circling the hole, ready to go down like one giant turd. This matchup, thankfully, won't be extremely long. I look for Santino to successfully retain the United States Championship. Woo. A comedy match. You know. From there, we go to something much better. The Intercontinental Championship will be on the line as Christian will defend the Intercontinental Belt against Cody Rhodes. They had a good match at the last pay-per-view Over the Limit. I expect them to have a decent match again on this pay-per-view. I look for Christian to retain the title, but it's going to be a close outing. I expect both wrestlers to come out looking pretty strong out of this matchup, and I see Cody Rhodes being on the road to a main event status, but there's a point where he's got to kind of let go of that mid-card belt position. So Christian to retain the Intercontinental Belt, that's my prediction. You have a Divas title match, Beth Phoenix versus Layla. I really, really, really want Beth Phoenix to win. It's hard to say that she will, but I'm gonna put my money, honestly, on Layla on this one. And not because I think Beth Phoenix can't do it, I just think that the WWE is waiting to put the belt back on Beth when Kong is ready to go. And I don't know whether or not Kong, Karma, whatever, is ever going to be ready to go again. You know, she went through a rather rough situation, and she's still employed by the WWE, but I got no clue when or if she's ever going to actually make a real in-ring return beyond her brief appearance at the Royal Rumble 6 months ago. We've been all anticipating, but at this point, it's starting to seem more and more unlikely. Speaking of weird people who have been missing, Eve has been kind of a non-corpus mendus the last couple of weeks. Anybody know where she's been? A little weird. The WWE Championship is on the line in a triple threat match. Kane versus CM Punk versus Daniel Bryan. I'm looking forward to this matchup. I think it's going to be very interesting, and it's got a good dynamic. Two solid technical wrestlers and one powerhouse machine. And we've got the intermixing of AJ, which I was a little wary about this whole thing, but I'm kind of enjoying the AJ storyline now. And I think that, honestly, it'll make a better wild card for the whole thing. I see CM Punk somehow retaining. I see AJ still lurking around with CM Punk. And I see probably a one-on-one match between Punk and Kane shortly down the road. Maybe at the next pay-per-view is Money in the Bank. Yeah, that seems like a decent place for them to have it. Yeah. So, I see CM Punk for that one. So CM Punk to win. And AJ is still going to be a factor for a while, in my opinion. World Heavyweight Championship. You've got Dolph Ziggler, who is now the new internet darling, taking on Sheamus for the World Heavyweight Championship. And, I'm sorry. I know that a lot of people have said, you know, Dolph needs to win this one. This is his big chance to, if he's not a main eventer, I still don't see the WWE giving it to him. But I think the WWE is smart enough to know that they are kind of short on solid babyface main eventers, and that maybe now is a good time to turn Ziggler face and have Jack Swagger and Vicky Guerrero double-cross him. Or have them accidentally cost him and have him walk away from them. Either way, it's time for Ziggler to get a separation from Vicky and Jack Swagger. They're the proverbial albatross around his neck. So I see Sheamus winning this one, but through dubious means, not necessarily on purpose dubious means, but dubious means nonetheless. Finally, probably the more confusing of matches that I've had to think about in recent history, and that is the Big Show versus John Cena inside of a steel cage. Now, the reason why this is confusing is because up until tonight, I was pretty sure Big Show was going to win. Up until tonight, everything seemed to be straight in line for the Big Show. Then they had a whole thing where a confrontation with Cena and Laurinaitis got heated, and of course Cena threatened to attack Laurinaitis, and Laurinaitis said, if you lay a hand on me, you're fired. And, of course, the board of directors had already said that the match is going to happen one way or another. So, Laurinaitis said, I'll fire you on Monday. Cena clocked him. So, one way or another, someone's getting fired. Now, I know, I weighed a lot of factors. I've been thinking about this for the last, hour and a half or so. In one hand, Cena is getting divorced. That takes a lot of time and pressure. But think of how many main eventers are injured and suspended right now. The WWE can't afford to lose another main eventer. Even if they were to turn Dolph Ziggler face, it's not going to be enough. And certainly, taking John Cena off TV is not what I think is going to come out of it. So this leaves only one of two options. One, John Cena wins, which then Laurinaitis will be fired and then probably become Big Show's manager instead of just being a general manager. That's a doable scenario without losing a main eventer, although it does kind of kill the whole, I'm a giant, not an entertainer! From the Big Show. And the other option is a draw. That both men get out of the cage at the exact same time. And while I'd like to think that the WWE is not that stupid to end their pay-per-view on a draw, it's still a distinct possibility. Now, I'm going to put my prediction in the John Cena wins category, with the addendum that a draw is a very reasonable but really, really, really shitty way to end your pay-per-view outcome possibility. So that's going to be No Way Out. And as you can tell just from my dubious feelings about it, this may turn out to be a really crappy pay-per-view. I certainly hope not. I hope whoever does pay for it gets their money's worth. All right. So I'll be back tomorrow with my top 20 favorite entrance themes of all time. And then on Sunday evening, after No Way Out is concluded, I will come back with my review of the pay-per-view. I'm Mr. Spiffy, and this barrel's been scraped clean. And I'll see you tomorrow.